Now, what happens when a small country gets export subsidy is, before the subsidy, the small country was facing the world price, which was PW. After the subsidy, the domestic prices would increase by the amount of the subsidy. So the new domestic price is PW plus subsidy. So the price increases by the amount of the subsidy. Now, before subsidy was imposed, the trade was this green shaded region on the x-axis. X-axis is measuring your quantity. So this much was exported before the subsidy. After the export subsidy was given, there was an increase in exports from this country, and that is given by your blue. The trade after subsidy is given is measured by the blue line. Change in consumer surplus is the area under the demand curve and between the two price changes. So that is A plus B. But since there is an increase in prices, there's a decline in consumer surplus. So the change in consumer surplus is negative. Change in producer surplus is the area above the supply function between the two price changes, and that is A plus B plus C. I repeat, change in producer surplus is A plus B plus C. Right? Now, government subsidy is the amount of exports after subsidy, amount of exports after subsidy times the amount of subsidy that is being given. And on the vertical axis, this is the amount of subsidy being given, and the new export level is the blue line here. So this whole rectangle is your subsidy cost, which consists of B plus C plus D. This is the effect of small country imposing a subsidy, giving an export subsidy.